looked like it was way too much work. I am not that excited. Good to be back in Boise. I just got back from a family reunion. Yeah, let me ask you something. You ever walk into the room at a family reunion, take one good look around, and realize that you should have started drinking like 3 hours ago? I'm like, oh, wow. I need to reconsider my position on abortion. This is not an attractive family. This is one gene pool that they really should just drain the water and fill it in with cement, I'm thinking. I took one good look around the room and I was like, I'm gonna have to lower my standards if I expect to get laid tonight. Reunion about 5 years ago, got drunk, and made a fool out of myself, started talking about trash. They got pissed, they kicked me out. And, well, they asked me to leave. Pretty sure that's what they said. I don't speak Spanish. Yeah, it wasn't my family. I'm an anomaly among most comics. I am 50 years old, and I have never smoked marijuana. Yep. And I'm going to tell you why. Because I've always believed that smoking marijuana led to a life of laziness, lost ambition, basically a life spent wasted sitting on the couch. And turns out that was Netflix. Well, it pisses me off. I could have been stoned this whole time. Pretty obvious I don't smoke marijuana because I still call it marijuana. You guys drinking tonight? Everybody drinking? Good. Did you see this in the news? A French liquor company recently announced that they started pouring their premium alcohol over the bare naked breast of Playboy models prior to bottling. They say that the process has a uniqueness you cannot find anywhere else. And I say, if that was true, then we could conclude that Budweiser pours their product over the ass cheeks of a homeless man. Power bottle. School. I'm just really sick and tired of sitting in traffic, waiting on teenagers to get off the bus and cross the goddamn street. Oh, shits. Let me ask you something. Is it really even necessary to bring the school bus to a complete stop? They're young, they're athletic. Can't they just open the back door and jump past the road, little shit? Sick of teenagers. I knew teenagers. I used to be a high school auto shop teacher. I taught high school for 3 years. So I worked very hard at it. And then once I realized I could just easily meet teenage girls online, in the back of the classroom once, they were taking chewing gum foil and they were folding it up into little strips and sticking it into the light socket, trying to short out the socket.
Oh, come
on. Yeah, my first thought was, well, if I wait long enough, this problem's gonna solve itself. Listen, parents, I think you know that your teenager's an idiot when they think the honor roll is a piece of bread they serve in the cafeteria. Here's your first clue. Another true story, I was teaching a lesson one day on secondary ignition systems. Now, if you're not familiar, a secondary ignition system, that's the high voltage side of the ignition system. That's the spark plug wires, and so forth. And I was telling the students, I go, look, when you're working on a car, don't touch the wires while the car is running, because you could get shocked. 50,000 volts traveling down that spark plug wire to ignite the fuel. And the student raises his hand and goes, has it ever happened to you, Mr. Weaver? And I'm like, yes, it has. Another student raises his hand and says, did it hurt? I know the next question, so I said, no. It does not hurt. I lied. Because the next question was, can we try it?
Yes, we can.
And I'm thinking, I'm quitting in December, so yes, we can. So I took the dumbest one in the bunch. I took it outside of the shop, and I had this old Dodge truck partially disassembled. It would crank over, but it wouldn't start, and I knew that. And I walked him over, and I walked him right into the truck, and I took the spark plug wire, and I put it around his hand, and I go, hold on tight now. I go, you take the other hand, and set it right there on the fender, because it needs a good ground. And he's smirking, and giggling, like a stupid idiot. And the rest of the class is standing around going, no freaking way. Bullshit. Ain't gonna happen. And I turn the key over.